TV.com right here with the man who just got one of the biggest wins of his career, Mike Galligan, Southpaw heavyweight, who just won on the Chiller card. Was it last Thursday? Yeah, last Thursday, first round knockout. How you feeling?
Feeling good. One day, it's my business like this.
Yeah. Did you expect an early knockout?
Or did Well, to be honest with you, I wanted to go up there and touch him, see how he handled the power, and depending on how he was going to react to it,
yeah,
regardless of what round it was, it's solely depending on how long he lasts, you know what I mean?
Yeah.
So, first clean shot I hit him with, dropped him, after that, kill
yeah. A lot of people don't know you're a southpaw. You are a southpaw. There's Zeke talk. What's up, Zeke? Yeah. A lot of people don't know you're a southpaw as well. So that was a bit tricky for him as well.
A lot of people don't want to fight the southpaw. It's a conventional fight, but you're gonna have to see it at some point.
Yeah.
Test them.
Yeah. You're moving, fainting them, you know, baiting them in with the feints, moving around. And once you hurt him with the left, you saw a wounded prey. You just jumped on him like a young Mike Tyson.
That's exactly what it was. Once he was hurt and I seen that he wasn't able to come back, I had to hop on him.
Yeah.
Give him no chance to recover. You know?
Yeah. Definitely. This is his coach, Zeke James Thompson. How you doing, Zeke?
Hey, buddy, how you doing?
I'm good out here working, trying to stay safe. This is head coach Zeke Thompson right here, for those who don't know. So, you know, you got a great win. I think I checked BoxRec, has you at number 7. So you're up there with, you know, Cassius Chaney, I want to say Deontay Wilder, you know, a bunch of, you know what I'm saying, big heavyweights. What was it like fighting a Chiller card?
The card was awesome. I mean, besides them messing up my name on my entrance, the production was sweet. No complaints over here. Everything was A1.
Yeah. Well, you the co-main, right?
I think they had a... Yeah,
okay.
I was a swing or something like that.
Okay. All right.
The second fight.
Okay.
Wouldn't have been the co-main, but they had so much suspicion, they brought another heavyweight fight in.
Uh-huh.
So they made Mike the second fight, which was good.
Yeah.
Because it got over so early, I was it was over so quick, you know. Yeah, it was wonderful, man. Wonderful.
Yeah.
Good win.
Yeah.
I saw Shannon the Cannon. What were you yelling to him?
Let's go champ. Let's go champ. I had to let him know Ray Mercer was back in there. And Ray Mercer was in full effect. So for all Morrisons,
yeah.
Ray Mercer. That's all they get is Ray Mercer.
Yeah. So, what'd you think of the stoppage? Did you want to, you know, put him completely out? Or?
I mean, during the the ref meetings in the dressing room, I mean, you get a feel from every ref. I know how I do, whether what type of ref they is, if they gonna let some shit go, if you got a chance.
Yeah.
From the feel I got from him, he was trying to take care of it. So, if he thought for a second that you wouldn't be able to defend yourself without getting hurt more, he was gonna call it. So, after that, I had him on the ropes and the ref. Standing there. I knew that was
right.
He wasn't gonna let me lose back
home
because I had him
up. Right. Yeah, that damn sure did look like a Morrison and Ray Mercer type knockout. The only difference is they didn't let you keep going.
The ref didn't step in. That's exactly what it was gonna be. That's exactly
what I think people were saying some stuff about he wasn't mentally there and all this, you know, excuses type stuff.
And you know, the funny thing about it is, they had a whole little thing in his dressing room where they gave his father trunks.
Uh-huh.
And they had a whole, I didn't learn until after the fight, they had a whole little B-roll with his family and his father history.
Yeah.
And he had to beat me.
Yeah.
So they was playing him. Yeah, I mean, he might have been emotional, but I mean, you know, a fight is a fight. That should go out the window. I know it's just me.
Pretty
much. For one thing only.
Yeah. I don't think, maybe I could be wrong, I don't think any fighter goes into a fight 100%, right? Whether it's physically.
Get his ass. For sure. You know, you got the mental stress, the physical stress.
Yeah.
Just the training camp and sparring, fighting every session. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
So it's a lot of stress. So 100% for sure.
I saw you talk to Lou before and after the fight. Are you signed with Lou DiBella? Yeah.
Yeah.
Okay. When did that happen?
I've been with Lou for like my last 5 fights.
Okay.
Five fights.
How did I know that?
Say it again.
I said, I did not know that.
Oh, yeah, yeah, yeah. We've been with Lou all 20. I think I signed that in the 2019.
Okay.
So all 2020. And then, yeah, all 2020. All my fights in 2020, and then the two I had in position.
Okay. So what does Lou have in store for you next?
Something big. You know, we strategic with our approach still. Yeah. You know what I mean? But it don't do nothing but that. We're not to fight down. You know what I mean?
It's a lot of guys in your weight class, obviously. What did you think of Cassius Chaney, his fight against Arias? Are you interested in him? Are you interested in...
I don't think I want to make lateral movements. You know what I'm saying? We want to go up. I feel like those guys are either on the same playing field as me or maybe a step up. No lateral movements. No lateral movements.
You're fighting for the prize at this point.
Absolutely. We need to be.
Yeah.
That ain't Cassius Chaney, no disrespect to none of them, but we trying to aim them up. They trying to aim them up. You know what I mean?
Right. I see you got your shirt on. You got the clothing line out?
Every fight we re-up. You know, we re-up. It ain't nothing that I'm selling or nothing like that. Just basically for the team, for the fans.
Okay. So if anybody want to buy any of your t-shirts, they couldn't?
I mean, yeah. They can message me. IG, Facebook, Silverback Valley on IG, same thing on Facebook. Contact me, get you a shirt, for sure.
All right, how much are your shirts if people want to purchase them?
20.
Okay.
20. All right.
How soon would you like to get back in the ring? I know we got a couple fights at the top of the year in this area. Would you want to fight in this area at the top of the year, or you just
wait? We look at first quarter, maybe February, late February, mid-March.
Okay.
First quarter next year.
Okay. All right. I did not know you were Sam and Lou. That's interesting.
Say it again.
I said I did not know you were Sam and Lou. That's interesting.
Yeah, we've been with Lou. I mean, it was announced, but it wasn't no big grand announcement. You know what I'm saying?
I wish I would have known. I would have, you know, helped.
You definitely go to the site, you know what I mean? Which nobody really goes to Lou. I'm on you, but yeah, we've been saying, you know, people that know me, now they go down.
All right. What would you like to do, you know, your ending goal in boxing?
Ending goal? I'm not doing this for play. I'm doing this because I'm trying to get to the top. So
right.
Belt, maybe a couple belts. Mm. You know, some M's would be, you know, nice.
Yeah.
But yeah, I mean, I'm in it for the long haul. I mean, however long that is, you know. I don't got time on my side, so we're gonna be trying to get where we need to go immediately, strategically, but for sure, immediately.
Right. You say time isn't on your side. You're not old. I'm not old.
I feel like this. I've been preserved. You know what I mean? I was a late bloomer and everything. You know,
right.
Even when it came to football, I didn't play high school football at all. You know what I mean? I went to JUCO, and then from there, excelled. And same thing to boxing. I'm taking that same blueprint, applying it to boxing, and it's going just as well. You know what I mean? So we on time.
This is fun.
We on time. Time is now. We on time.
Okay. Any message to any heavyweight out there that's listening, any champion or whoever that's watching?
Look, don't be scared. Run that fade for the bread. That's what we do, right? You know what I'm saying? I run that fade for the bread anywhere, anytime. So, you know, fuck all the strategy and trying to stay away from guys who's most dangerous. I mean, ain't that where you prove yourself? You know, you stepping in with somebody who they say most dangerous.
Mm-hmm.
I feel like the game is watered down by safe haven, safe plays. You know what I mean? But we coming. I mean, we here. Dangerous, most dangerous southpaw in the game right here at the division. Easy, not even comparable. But we looking for everybody, anybody that makes sense. You know what I'm saying?
Mm. No doubt.